Okay, in this study, we're going to actually mix a surface body and a solid body in the study. So, I don't know what that study advisor is about. They never went into it. I'll bet you that fucking study advisor is just a wizardized version of going through it the manual way, like they keep showing us. Okay, so this is supposed to be. Supposed to be a static study. Okay, now this is actually the icon for a surface body shell mesh, and that's for solid mesh. Now it's supposed to. Select properties here. And under solver, select direct sparse. Click OK. Okay, so anyway, so we got that shell part, right? Okay, so I got to right click on it. And edit definition, and I'm going to select 5 millimeters as its thickness. Anyway, I'm gonna go select the ductile iron, the iron type, or the iron menu, whatever the shit that is. Okay, ductile iron. Okay. You know, I guess this ready study is something they've already made. You know, it's a finished result. And see, it looks like you can add these things to the library too. I'm supposed to drag this from here to this other study somehow, so I guess that did it. I don't know. Pressure one. Fixture one. And mixed one. Solid. Okay. Yeah, it does have a little cursor there. See that circle changes. So I don't know if pressure one ever got added though. I don't think it got added. Huh. There it goes. Okay. So, I guess you can drag properties like that from one study to another. Okay, we're going to add something called a link connector. I don't know what it's for yet. Now, under type, where the vertex is first location, which is right here, I'm going to select this point. And in the vertex for the second location, I'm going to select this point. Okay, and then select OK. Oh, I was supposed to pin that thing, but so I need to hit link again. I was supposed to pin it, so I could do a similar thing for this. Different color might be nice here. I guess it's too late. Alright. And the global contact type is still bonded, so. Okay. Now, shit. Okay, now I need to go hit create mesh. Points 4, automatic trial selected, trials 3, stress plot and an SX. Okay, I need to under display. I need to select SX X normal stress in the component PSI top and shell face. Okay, under deformed shapes, select user defined. Type 1 for the scale factor, and then click OK. Certainly must have missed something, because you know this is what it's supposed to look like, not like this. So you know, that is definitely not right. true scale with very little deflection. These are defined, there's hardly any deflection either. Kind of wonder what's going on with that. Well, wouldn't one imply a scale factor of 1 to 1? You see, my plot certainly didn't come out the same. It's like the shit's not hinged. Although this is kind of interesting to me, though, really, because it shows the deflection of it. You know, as a flap or whatnot. Whereas this is how it's supposed to be, but it's got these anchors that are missing from mine. So, it must have something to do with that hinge thing, and maybe it's because I fucked up and didn't have it pinned open or something. I have no idea. So here's what it's supposed to look like, you know, for those constraints. Because I know it's obviously supposed to be some sort of constraint. See a slight deflection in it, so you know, it's the actual deflection. So anyway, like I said, let's go look at mine. But like I said, I kind of think this is an interesting result too. Of course, there's not some more convenient motherfucking way of animating this. Okay. Now let's see what the true results look like. Okay. Animate that motherfucker. So, yeah, it's more of a deflection there without it being hinged. I have no idea what load they really applied, since I just copied and pasted everything. Let's see, where are the loads? Here we go. It's about 3 psi? Yeah. So that's only a 5 millimeter thick cast iron part.